Good afternoon, gang. Welcome to Free Teach and this tutorial on rules for the 10th term. Okay. Where's my pen gone? Should be there. Okay, rules for the 10th term. So when we're talking about the 10th term, we are with these rules, which is just there. Difference to a recurrence rule is that we can find any term as far along the relation as we want. So instead of like a recurrent relation having to build one term upon another, we can go and jump straight to the 10th year, for instance, and that will allow us to just look at different things a bit quicker than having to build up recurrent relations the whole way along. Okay. So the first thing that we're asked to do here, we're given the term, the recurrent relation. Now, the reason that this works is that every time we build, we're given the rule for the nth term, not the recurrent relation, is that in the past, when we build a recurrent relation, all we would do is multiply the last value by the rate of increase or decrease again. Okay, so that means that we would be multiplying 1.09 in this case by 1.09 by 1.09. So if we're doing over 3 years, it'd look something like that. And at some point, that would have initially been multiplied by the 10,000. Okay. Now, all that's doing is that is just taking 1.09, and hopefully we can identify that that would be 1.09 by 10 to the 3 multiplied by 10,000. And that's why our rule for the nth term looks like it does. So first part, part A, we want to find the value of the investment after 4 years, correct to the nearest cent. So the key things here are that it's per annum, 9% per annum, and there's nothing about the compound interest being earned on a different period. So we can just take that n is 1 year, every year is the value of 1 for n. All right, so for instance, so we're looking for V4, and that will be equal to 1.09 power of 4 times 10,000. Okay, pop that into your calculator. And we get the value of 14,115 dollars, and 82 cents to the nearest cent. Okay. Okay. Part B: find the amount of interest earned after 4 years, correct to the nearest cent. Okay, now the amount of interest earned, so anything above, so there's nothing else going into this account. So anything above the 10,000 that we're told is initially invested is interest earned. So the difference between, I'll make that four look a bit better, the difference between the value of the account after 4 years, so the 14,000 figure, and the initial investment is going to be how much interest was earned. So if we do 14,115, 82 cents, take $10,000. Hopefully we can just about do this in our heads. We get 4,115 dollars and 82 cents is the value of interest earned after 4 years. Part C, find the amount of interest earned in the fourth year, correct to the nearest cent. Okay, so for this, we need to work out, really, it's the growth. So for part C, what we're going to be looking at, oops, that's not a C. So for part C, what we're going to be looking at is the difference between the value of the count in the fourth and the third years, because however much the account gets bigger in that fourth year, then that's going to be the amount of interest earned in the fourth year. So if we go along and find V3, then that'll give us the value of the account after 3 years, and we've already found the value of the account after 4 years, so that's why I'm doing it this way. So plug in 1.09 power of 3 times 10,000, we get 3. And now what we could do is we could take, as a sidetrack, we could find 9% of that value. That'll also give us the answer. So 9% of that is going to be what's built, how much is built on top of that. So 9% of that balance is the next lot of interest that's going to be accrued. But like I said, I can also do it by doing, change color. Doing 14,115.82. Take 12,950.29, and we get a figure there of $1,165.53. Okay. Now, fourth part of the question, is part C, up here. If interest compounds monthly instead of yearly, write down a rule for the value of the investment after N months. Okay, so now when it changes to monthly, we know that to find our rate, okay, we need to divide our interest by 12 first. Okay, so we could think of it as like this. 9 divided by 12 divided by 100. Okay, so 9 divided by 12 is 0.75. So 0.75 over 100. So the rate of change there, it'll be 1.0075, and we need to write that as a rule. All right, we cannot leave it just as, you know, sometimes we forget to complete the question. So for the rule in terms of the months, VN would be equal to 1.0075 the power of n multiplied by 10,000. Okay. And just to correct that up here, that's D. Part E wants us to use the rule to find the value of the investment after 4 years. Okay. Okay, so what we end up with there is a value of 14,314.05. Okay. And there's a little comparison you can make between our part A and part E. So both of them were applied over 4 years. This was 48 months for the compound interest application. But for the 4 years, when it was applied annually, we got $14,115. When it's applied monthly, we got almost nearly $200 in interest because it's applied more regularly. Okay, so this one is our monthly interest rate. So even though our rate of change is much smaller at 1.075 compared to 1.09, because it's applied 12 times a year, the compound interest accrues much more quickly. Okay, hopefully that helps, guys. If it's all good, give it a thumbs up.